Greediness will make you do the wrong things in life and make you make bad decisions. The Bible has no instance of a person specifically selling his soul and making a deal with the devil, but this is a common question we receive. After coming across the story of Dr. Faustus, a lot of people have the question, is it possible to sell your soul? Although this story is not a biblical story, it is used as a cautionary tale on the effects and dangers of sin. The story of Dr. Faustus is of a well-respected German scholar who grows dissatisfied with the limits of traditional forms of knowledge, logic, medicine, law, and religion, and decides that he wants to learn to practice magic. His friends Valdez and Cornelius instruct him in the black arts, and he begins his new career as a magician by summoning up Mephistopheles, a demon. Despite Mephistopheles' warnings about the horrors of hell, Faustus tells the devil to return to his master, Lucifer, with an offer of Faustus' soul in exchange for 24 years of service from Mephistopheles. Mephistopheles returns to Faustus with word that Lucifer has accepted Faustus' offer. Faustus experiences some misgivings and wonders if he should repent and save his soul. In the end, though, he agrees to the deal. And long story short, for the next 24 years, Dr. Faustus wreaks havoc and goes across the world wreaking havoc with his magic that has been given as a result of his deal. As the 24 years of his deal with Lucifer come to a close, Faustus begins to dread his impending death. An old man urges Faustus to repent, but Faustus drives him away. But time is growing short. Faustus tells the scholars about his pact, and they are horror-stricken and resolve to pray for him. On the final night before the expiration of the 24 years, Faustus is overcome by fear and remorse. He begs for mercy, but it is too late. At midnight, a host of devils appear and carries his soul off to hell. The Bible does not support this cautionary tale, but the Bible does say, Mark 8:36, "For what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? What is the price you have placed on your soul? What have you exchanged your soul for?" Daniel 12:2, "Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, but others to shame and everlasting contempt." Do not be deceived by the enemy of your mind into thinking that your soul does not matter, because it does. Our soul is the part of us that will live forever. The spirit of man does not cease when our fleshly bodies pass away in death. Our souls will live forever, either in the presence of God in heaven, if we are saved, or in punishment in hell, apart from God, if we reject Jesus, who is God's gift to humanity for the atonement of our sins. Trust me, nothing in this world or on this world is worth your soul. I believe one of the reasons why people are willing to gain this world at the cost of their soul is because of the spirit of avarice. Avarice is a real thing. Avarice is greed. 1 Timothy 6, 6-8 says, "But godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us be therewith content. But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition." Those that are godly and content with the little they have do not sometimes appreciate who they are. Godliness with contentment is great gain, but people who are greedy and are not satisfied with what God has given to them usually pierce themselves with sorrows. It is very bad to be greedy and covetous. Greediness destroys. Greediness will make you act foolishly by doing the wrong things. No greedy person will ever act wisely. There are several people who steal to amass wealth. Some kidnap people for money, but they are never satisfied, even after they have amassed such a great wealth through their evil deed. Their greed will never allow them to be contented. they will continue to want more wealth until they are finally caught. The Bible says that if we have food and clothes, that we should be contented with them. This does not in any way mean that God wants His people to live in poverty. But at the same time, it is not all wealth that is amassed in godly ways. Being wealthy is not a sin. Wanting a better life for your family and yourself is not a sin. Don't let anyone tell you that wanting to provide a better life for your family is a sin. It only becomes a problem when you are doing these things at the expense of your soul. The ends of greedy people are always bad. The Bible says that they will end up falling into temptation and into many foolish lusts, which will eventually lead to their destruction. There are countless numbers of things people can be greedy for. Some people can do anything to get money. Some can do anything to get a certain position. While some men are greedy for women, they are never satisfied with their wives. These kind of men make foolish decisions of leaving their wives and children to cater for a woman who will never add any value to their lives. Worse still, the satisfaction they want to derive from another woman will not be granted even after they have wasted their time and resources. Greed is like a worm that eats deep into the fabrics of people. A greedy person is blinded to what is right. Their passion is geared towards what they want without counting the cost. The cost of covetousness or greed is very high. No one can pay it. People who try to amass wealth in ungodly ways will end up having their needs met. And even when they have gathered much through greed, the joy of having true wealth will be absent in their lives.
There are some verses in the Bible that are so wonderful and poignant that they transcend into the lives even of the unconverted. For example, you reap what you sow. People think this is just an old saying, but it comes from the Bible. And another statement which even unbelievers know is, money is the root of all evil. Although it is quoted slightly differently, its basis can actually be found in the Bible in 1 Timothy 6:10 through 11. The love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. But thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Rather than money being the root of all evil, it's not. Money is a wonderful thing that God created. What is the root of all evil? It is the love of money. Unbelievers and even Christians are guilty of the love of money, greed, avarice, covetousness. How do I know I am greedy? How do I know I am avarice? If you are seeking the accumulation of wealth, the accumulation of things, more diligently than you are pursuing righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness, you are an avarice person. Avarice is loving money more than God. Avarice is loving material things more than God. Greed is why people sell their souls to the devil. The Bible has no instance of a person selling his or her soul to Satan, and it never implies that making a bargain with the devil is possible. However, we do see in Matthew 4:8 through 9 at the temptation of Jesus. Satan offers Jesus rule over the world with this temptation, though at a very high price. Paul calls the devil the god of this world in 2 Corinthians 4:4, and Jesus himself later refers to Satan as the ruler of the world in John 12:31. So Satan offered to hand over the keys of the world to Jesus in exchange for being worshipped by the Son of God. So, in helping others as believers, the devil may not offer you the world like he did to the Lord Jesus, but he can offer you a job or something attractive that will give you unmoral money, or he may tempt you into cheating your way into success. Don't sell your soul because of greed. Greed shows itself in dishonesty, if it will lead to gain. You see people cheating and lying on their tax returns, not knowing that the spirit avarice is working in them. The Bible does not condone such things. Jesus himself, when speaking about taxes in Mark 12:14 through 17, stated, "Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's." Greed will cause people to steal, to walk around with money and possessions that belong to others. Matthew 6:19. Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal.